and we are part of GIN, which is Global Issues Network, and we're going to present to you about biodiversity and ecosystem loss in Bolivia.
But before we start, we wanted to get to know you a little better, and we would like to start with a little icebreaker in which you tell us about your names and something that you like to do. So if you can start up here.
My name is Maria Fernanda, and I like baking.
Mm-hmm. My name is Kayla, and I like reading.
My name is Lucia, and I like to cook.
I'm very interesting. My name, like Nadia said already, is Christelle, and I like animals.
My name is Nadia, and I like to play tennis. And our main goal is to spread awareness about biodiversity and ecosystem loss in Bolivia.
Yeah. So biodiversity and ecosystems, what are they and why are they important? So if we pollute the air, water, and soil, that keeps us alive and well and destroy the biodiversity that allows natural systems to function, no amount of money will save us. I can't imagine anything more important than air, water, soil, energy, and biodiversity. These are the things that keep us alive.
So, what is biodiversity? So, as you may know from biology class, bio means life, and diversity means variety. So, biodiversity is all of the variety of species on Earth. For example, plants, animals, every plant and every animal is part of a place's biodiversity. And Bolivia is a very biodiverse country since it has different altitudes ranging from Santa Cruz, which is really low, and La Paz, which is really high. And different animals live in these places because the temperature and the climates are different.
So what are ecosystems? Ecosystems are the interaction of all of these living things in an area. Ecosystems are made up of soil, energy or heat, sunlight, water, and living organisms, which include plants, animals, and decomposers. They vary widely in size, and they can be as small as a puddle and as big as an ocean or a desert or a lake.
So why are these important? So when there is a lot of biodiversity, this means that there is a lot of species of animals and of plants, and this allows sustainable food chains, and food chains don't break, because if there's less of a species, one species will overpopulate and they will eventually run out of food. And also it ensures natural sustainability for the ecosystems. And ecosystems are important because most of the medicine we drink when we're sick are found in the natural, are found in nature, such as herbs, trees, and many other factors. And also, as you may know, forests supply oxygen. Trees give us life.
So here are some Bolivian statistics about biodiversity and ecosystem loss. So there are 1,350 different bird species found only in Bolivia, 17,367 different plant species, and 316 different mammals.
So some extra stats. Bolivia is the 8th most biodiverse country in the world. And this is because of what we mentioned of the different altitudes. And 17% of Bolivia are national parks and also protected areas. And 3.5% of the world's tropical rainforests are found in Bolivia. And also Bolivia contains 4 biomes and 199 ecosystems. And biomes are the different habitats that the animals live in, such as deserts, places where it snows, tundras.
So dangers in Bolivia. How are we losing biodiversity and ecosystems, and what species are endangered here in this country?
So more than 350,000 hectares have been lost because because of annually, because of deforestation, because we cut trees, we burn them because of agriculture purposes, or because we want to build houses or buildings.
So 28 bird species are already endangered in Bolivia, along with 70 plant species and 24 mammals.
So other endangered animals include the, and in the next slide we will show you pictures of these animals, the Andean hairy armadillo, the Bolivian chinchilla rat, the Amazon river dolphin, the blue-throated and red-fronted macaws, the pampas deer, the castor water frog, the jaguar, Darwin's rhea, and the Cochabamba mountain finch. And we later will show you a website in which we will go more in depth on these animals.
And here are some pictures.
You can see all the animals that we mentioned. Here's the jaguar,
and Darwin's rhea, and
the deer,
the Bolivian chinchilla rat, and the Amazon river dolphin, which are already extinct in China. Some endangered plants include the Amarena centiflora, the Acacia atilis, the Brazil nut tree, the fig tree, the Palo Papel, and the Zamia boliviana. There are many more, but these are just some of them. And so here's the Palo Papel, the Acacia atilis, and the Brazil nut tree, which are very close to extinction.
So why are we losing this? We're using them, one reason is animal trafficking. People sell this to gain a profit. Sometimes people sell them in the markets, in the black markets, to make money. They make wallets or clothing out of these animals, and you have to kill them for that. And also there's a lot of destruction of the habitats because of mining projects such as El Chaco and Oriente for purposes of gaining a profit. Also, there is an over-exploitation of soil resulting from monoculture, and some people use fertilizers too much, and that endangers the habitat the animals live in, and this can kill them. So here is some trafficking of animals. You see that they're in cage. There you see the jaguar fangs, which we will talk about later, which are really valuable in some markets.
And baby alligators all in a box.
Turtles.
The turtle and the monkeys and chains. The birds all packed in a cage. These are some of the things that animals have to live with in animal trafficking. So the solution, what can we do about this? So how to stop this?
So we can try and buy organic and local foods, and don't buy bad souvenirs. And by bad souvenirs, we mean don't buy things that we know that an animal had to be killed to produce it, such as wallets made out of animal skin, or maybe there are some coats which are really warm, but they use animal skin to make it, so they had to kill the animal. Don't buy things made up with animal parts, because you wouldn't like people to do that to you. And also reduce waste. Try to use the less plastic. Try to buy a water bottle. And if you once buy a plastic water bottle, recycle it. Reuse, reduce, and recycle. And then also try to help restore habitats. Try to donate money to organizations which are trying to restore their habitats. And most importantly, never buy wildlife. Like in the streets, they may be really cheap, but don't buy them because they don't belong. They are not meant to be pets. They belong in the wild. And also try to reduce fertilizer and pesticide use. And don't try to donate money, or if not money, try to donate your time to protect wildlife.
So we have some questions about our presentation to test what you learned, and we have some prizes if you answer them. So let's go on. what are ecosystems? Maria Fernanda again.
Ecosystems are where the animals live, so like biomes and
their habitats.
Their habitats.
Exactly. So next question, we want to see some participation from our other contestants. Why is biodiversity important? Does anybody remember?
Kayla.
One factor of why they're important is that they help sustain food chains like the
Exactly.
Exactly.
Now, our next question, why are ecosystems important? The habitats of animals, why are they important?
Because that's their home, that's where they live.
Exactly.
Like, that's where animals live.
Yeah, great job.
Exactly.
Exactly.
Here's a prize.
You see that you learned a lot. And what are some endangered animals in Bolivia? Let's go in order. Lucia and Kayla.
That's an Amazon River dolphin.
Mm-hmm.
When I went to Beni, I actually swam with those.
Oh my god. Wow. So we have a person that experienced swimming with an Amazon River dolphin. That's very cool. Kayla?
The jaguar.
The jaguar, yes. Very, very close extinction.
The blue macaw,
yeah,
mentioned, and also the chinchilla.
Ah, the Bolivian chinchilla rat. And what are some endangered plants in Bolivia? Kayla.
The Brazilian nut tree.
Yeah, exactly. And anybody else remember another name?
Yes, there was one that was like acacia.
Yeah, bravo. Good job, Kayla. What can we do to stop biodiversity and ecosystem loss worldwide, not even only in Bolivia?
Stop buying bad like tours on souvenirs.
Exactly, yeah.
For
exactly.
Example, stop buying things that come from animals.
Mm-hmm.
I know that many people who come here take like jaguar fangs and
mm-hmm.
we can stop that.
Yeah, exactly.
Very good.
That's very good. That's a big problem here in Bolivia.
And we will talk about jaguar fangs right now. It's a very big problem.
Yeah.
We can also donate our time or money to different efforts that work with protecting ecosystems worldwide.
Exactly.
Exactly.
Like the World Wildlife Fund is a very famous one.
Exactly.
Anybody else?
I think that's the last question.
Uh-huh. People deserve to be happy too. Those are the blue and yellow macaws. And now we will show you our website and we will go more into detail about some of these animals and the animal trafficking here in Bolivia. And we should pay attention because we will have a kahoot about it.
So biodiversity trafficking in Bolivia, and get educated from the heartbreaking reality that we live in.
Mm-hmm. Who are we? Nadia and Christelle, and what is biodiversity? The variety of animals, our life on Earth, not only animals.
You can
roll
more down. Okay, so Walter Andrade Sanjines is in charge of protecting wildlife in Bolivia, and he says that there are only 50 police officers in charge of protecting wildlife, and they don't live in the provinces, they only live in the capitals. And in the provinces, a lot of animal trafficking happens too, and this doesn't protect wildlife like it should be protected.
Yeah, for so many species that there are here in Bolivia, only 50 officers is not a very big help. So animal trafficking is the fourth illegal business that generates the most money worldwide, It generates anywhere from $10 billion to $20 billion. That's why the animals are always being trapped.
And there is a guy who lived in Beni, which was in charge of protecting wildlife, and he said he once went to a fair in which they were selling wallets made out of jaguar skin and things, souvenirs, this band souvenirs that we were talking about before, all those kind of things were on sale. And he tried to stop and arrest the ones that were selling them, but they threatened to kill him like with a gun, so he could not stop them. And he says that people truly live off that. They don't work, they dedicate their jobs are to traffic animal and to make products out of their skin or other parts.
So our goal, like, spread news about the trafficking to the world. And here's a link to donate to one of Bolivia's conservation efforts. It's in Lopez in Cochabamba, in the heartland of Bolivia. It's called the Inti Guarayasi, so you can donate to this link.
We will send you the website by email later if you want to donate. Okay, so the jaguar. This is Bolivia's new trafficking victim. And until 2009, the jaguar's greatest threat was losing their habitat due to agriculture purposes. But starting in 2014, a new threat arrived, and this is trafficking their teeth or fangs. And people use these fangs, it's a symbol of wealth and status in China, and they're trafficked to China. And the demand of jaguars has skyrocketed. And here is there was a man named Jesus who lived in Pando, and he once said a jaguar was about to kill him, so Jesus killed the jaguar first, and he took the jaguar home. And 2 days later, a Chinese person knocked on his door, and he said he offered $214 for each teeth. And Jesus instantly sold it because he wasn't going to do anything with the teeth. But then he discovered that this teeth was worth up to 10 times more in China's black markets. The price of jaguar teeth in China are very high because it's a symbol of wealth and status, and they use it to make jewelry. Here you can see, and here.
A bracelet.
So the richest people in China and in Asian countries are using this to symbolize their wealth. And a complete jaguar with all its genitals and skin can cost anywhere from $2,000 to $3,000. And in Asian markets, it can reach $20,000. So it's worth much more when it's already trafficked to China. And many police officers have found in the airports people trying to traffic the teeth.
So there's only 4,000 to 7,000 jaguars left in Bolivia, and we can still do something to stop this animal jaguar trafficking. Our next trafficking victim are the birds and turtles. Here are the blue and yellow macaws, which are very little worldwide, and especially here in Bolivia. So in Spanish, it's called Paraguay Azul. And this beautiful bird, as you can see in the picture above, there's only 350 left in the world. And this is due to illegal trafficking, due to high prices. And people buy them for pets mainly. They don't, and for costumes, they, as you may have seen in Brazilian Carnival, all those amazing costumes, so very pretty and everything, they are made with azules, and they are sold in the international market, as I said, to decorate costumes for dances. There are 18 birds are needed to make a single costume. So they have recently created more supervised places since there are so few left. But do we really have to wait until they are dead?
So here's a quote which said, "It is not whether the animals will survive, it's whether men have the will to save them." So we are the ones killing the animals. And turtles in Bolivia are called petas, and they're commonly wanted as pets. And what people do is they buy them because they're so cute when they're small, but that eventually they start to grow up and get old, and they start to stink, they start to smell bad. And what people do is they throw them to the trash, or they stop feeding them because they don't want their house to smell bad, and they end up dead. And it is illegal to buy these, but people unfortunately transport them to the black markets, and they're so fragile that for every one turtle that arrives in the black markets, it means that 50 others have died in the way. So recently, 39 turtles were rescued from the black market, but unfortunately, this means that over 1,950 of them have died on the way. Here you can see them. Here they're being rescued. They're very small, that's why they die so fast.
So there's at least 120 species in Bolivia subject to trafficking. And here is the hairy Andean armadillo. So the hairy Andean armadillo is also a subject of trafficking, and they're mainly used for cultural purposes like the Ucopiña festival. And here they use them as percussion instruments, or like you can see here, they are used for decoration, like they are wrapping some money around for all of these indigenous beliefs. And some people buy them as pets, but armadillos are not friendly, and therefore people get rid of them because they start biting, or like they're just not, like, they're not pets. They're not domesticatable.
So the cappuccino monkeys, so these are one of the most intelligent in the world, and they are very cute, as you can see in the pictures. And this is why many people want them as pets. They want to have them in their houses for them to look pretty, to play with them. But unfortunately, these are not meant to be pets. Therefore, they start to bite. They start to bite family members. And when one person has them as a pet and they start to bite the family members, they often get rid of them, and they don't take the time to go and donate it to the zoo. They just leave it out in the streets, and they die.
So that's it about
animal trafficking. These are some of the species we wrote. We chose to go into depth because these are the ones that are mostly threatened by trafficking. And now we will play at the woods. Well, do you have any questions? Anything?
Any questions at all? Okay. So if you have your phones, I'm pretty sure you do, because... Okay.
So now we will show you a short video, which is basically what we have covered, but to refresh your minds a little bit. And then we will play at the woods to see what you learned.
So pay attention to the video. It's not very long. Very short, but it's very informative. Mm-hmm. seconds for each question. So we hope you have fun, and we will test how much you learned with us.
This way we're protecting the ecosystem, as we say before, because we're not using paper.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And by not using paper, we're not cutting down trees, and we're avoiding deforestation and the loss of habitat of many animals.
And we hope you buy a water bottle for school on Monday. Good job, girls. Monkeys are crazy. They belong in the wild.
not as pets.
Exactly.
$10 to $20 billion.
That's sad.
Help us spread the word.
Okay, guys.